I made a rule for myself about 15 years ago that I wouldn't do anything for money that I wasn't willing to do for free. And that kept me focused really entirely on the hardcore world-changing stuff. And when I could get paid for it, I got paid for it. And when I couldn't get paid for it, I didn't. How do we then provide enough natural resources processed in a correct way to every human being so that nobody dies of poverty? Nobody dies of poverty. Nobody dies of poverty.
The potential, right? The potential. What could happen if it all works? The reason that we can't seem to get sensible policy out of the world is because we've got 200 or 300 or 500 year old institutions running on archaic technology. I mean, can you imagine if the transportation system was locked at a 200 year old level of technology in the same way that the political system is locked at 200 years old? If there is evidence, the decision should be made on the basis of the evidence. Slow, methodical, diligent work towards long-term freeing of humanity from fear. Because we basically got into this idea that the unknown was for eating. You know, the unknown was not for resting on, it was not for staring at, it was not for worshipping, it was for eating. We're going to eat the unknown and we're going to make science with it. In an age when, you know, some pissed off Palestinian 50-year-old could, you know, print out a copy of the smallpox virus in 20 years and just release it. And I, you know, I really wonder sometimes whether the entire kind of surface of the war and terror that we see on the news is actually just a cover for something which is absolutely about biological weapons. Figure out how to make a geodesic dome with no waste. And I was sort of like, oh, that's a really interesting question. And I spent about 6 months off and on trying to optimize Buckminster Fuller's math, didn't get anywhere with it, gave up. This is too hard, don't know how to do it. 6 years later, when I was in Colorado, somebody asked me, you know, could you make a refugee shelter that could be taken apart, transported, and then put back up again? And about 15 minutes later, I had the hexier on the back of a napkin. We're taking the shared stuff of humanity and we're mangling it in ways which are absolutely undemocratic because the people affected by the mangling of the climate are not actually getting a vote on what happens. It's improper to me, at a very basic level, that anybody should die for lack of material stuff within the parameters of the material stuff that every human being could have without depriving anybody else of their basic stuff. I haven't even talked about how the rising tide of technology is going to pull people out of poverty in 20 years, but it is. It could all work out pretty well. You know, this whole Mars thing is running along excellently. The knowledge that we might wipe ourselves out has gotten really deeply soaked into our deep minds. 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 Because we don't seem to have the ability to say no to technology. We always build it. I think it'd be nice to get the 60 million people that are currently in refugee camps into really nice little pod houses. We could do it. We need this to survive as a species because we've got to deal with global warming, nanotechnology, biotechnology, 10 billion human beings sharing a little planet, and the politics of interplanetary and then interstellar colonization. All that's happening within your lifetime and mine. There's a kind of traditional New Age certainty that there's kind of, you know, species-level awakening coming and all the rest of this sort of stuff. You know, this sort of Terence McKenna vibe, and I'm sure you've heard that until you're just purple in the ears. I don't think it's that, and I don't think it's Marxist historical inevitability or any of that stuff. What I think is coming is a species-level panic response. Oh my God, we're all gonna die. We have to work together to avoid all dying. There's a book called Paradise Built in Hell about spontaneous cooperation after large-scale natural disasters. And I think that there's a pretty decent chance that we're going to experience a moment like that in response to the man-made disasters that we're currently beginning to live in.